हेलो गाइस, दिस टाइम आई हैव कम विथ दिस गेट 2019 मैथमेटिक्स क्वेश्चंस ऑफ मेटलर्जी। सिर्फ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वन ऑफ द आइगन वैल्यूज फॉर द फॉलोइंग मैट्रिक्स इज, सो द मैट्रिक्स इज दिस राइट, ए 8 टू ए। नाउ टू फाइंड द आइगन वैल्यूज हाउ डू वी राइट, वी सब्ट्रैक्ट सम वैल्यू लैम्डा इन द डायगनल राइट, and after that we take the determinant and determinant should be equal to 0 right. So determinant of this will be equal to a minus lambda whole square minus 8 into 16 is equal to 0. This implies a minus lambda whole square is equal to 16. This implies a minus lambda is equal to plus minus 4. It can be 4 also, it can be minus 4 also. So now suppose this is 4, then lambda is equal to case 1 plus 4 right. So lambda is equal to a minus 4 and suppose it is minus 4, suppose it is minus 4, then lambda is equal to a plus 4 okay. So there are two values of this eigenvalues, there are two eigenvalues a minus 4 and a plus 4. So among this see which option will be correct, so a minus 4 okay, and the other will be a plus 4. A plus 4 is does not match with anyone right, so option A. Next, the curl of vector fields shown below is not zero okay. So we know suppose we have curl and with some vector f, if it is 0 what does it mean, it means irrotational, that means it cannot be rotated, that vector is not rotating right. So you can see here in the first case it is a straight line vector right, here also you can see these all are straight line vectors, these are straight line vectors, but if you see here the vectors, the direction of the vector is always changing right, so that means this is rotational. So the curl of this f will not be equal to 0, simple. So this is very logical okay. Next, the smallest period of function fx equal to sin nx by k is okay. So the function we have sin nx by k right. Now what do you mean by the period? Period means a certain interval after which the value repeats right. See, I'm drawing the sin x curve, so this is like this. So see here, when we draw this y is equal to simple sin x, then the value is changing from here, from 0 to 1 it is going, then again 0, but after this point it is going in the negative direction right, then it is coming and it is touching this x axis at this some x value where this y value will be 0. Now if you see again, so again the similar graph goes right, so that's why the period is here 2 pi, that means after this 2 pi the complete value are repeating okay. So this is for sin x, but here what is the form, what is the function here, it is sin n by k x, so n by k is some constant right. So we can say when we have this y is equal to sin x, then the period is 2 pi. So it is like 2 pi divided by 1. What is just before x, it is 1. So it is like 2 pi by 1. So now if we have this n by k, so the period will be 2 pi by n by k. So it will be nothing but 2 pi k by n okay. So it matches with option C, right? So always remember guys, when we need to find for period sine lambda x, then period will be 2 pi by lambda. I think these things must have studied in your class 12 also. Okay, so this is somewhat question from, you can say, like from our intermediate. Okay, next, the directional derivative of phi is equal to x square plus y along the unit vector u 1 by 5 3 I plus 4 j. Okay, so this is the unit vector. Okay, because the unit of this will be equal to 1. Okay, this is a unit vector. Now, so the directional derivative, so it is telling you to find the directional derivative. So first we will have to find the derivative, then we will have to take the dot product with this unit vector, because dot product with some vector leads in the same direction, right? So dot product, let us take the dot product, but before that we need to find the derivative, directional derivative, directional derivative. So how do you find this derivative? So like it will be like this, right? It will be like lambda by lambda x phi I plus lambda phi by lambda phi j, right? Because here it talks about x and y only, so we'll take two variables, x and y. Okay, so here it will be like lambda x square plus y lambda x I lambda x square plus y lambda y j. It will be 2x plus 1. Okay, here because x here it will be like 0, differentiation of x square will be 0 and y it will be 1. Okay, so it is 2xi plus 1j, right? Now this is a derivative, but along this direction, so we'll have to take dot product. So if you take this dot product, so it will be 2xi plus j dot 1 by 5 3i plus 4j. So it will be 1 by 5 2x, it will be like 6x, okay, plus 4 into 1 4. Okay, fine. Now guys, so we need to find this directional derivative at point 1 1. So x equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. So here we have x only, so we will put x value of x, so 6 into 1 plus 4, so it will like 10 by 5, so it will be 2. Okay, so it matches with option B, right? Next one, the standard deviation rounded off to one decimal place, so rounded off to one decimal place, so the following set of five numbers. So basically it is a set of five numbers. Okay, so then since the number is low, so it represents a sample, some kind of sample. Okay, you can consider it as a sample or you can consider it as a whole also, right? So now to find the standard deviation, first we need to find the mean. Mean is like x bar, so x bar will be equal to 6 plus 8 plus 8 plus 9 plus 9 divided by 5. So this will be equal to 6 8 14 14 8 22 31 40. So 40 by 5 is equal to 8. Fine. Now to find the standard deviation for a sample, standard deviation, you know the formula, it is sigma x minus x bar whole square by n minus 1 to complete 1 by 2. Okay, so this will be equal to sigma, it will be like 6 minus 8 whole square plus 8 minus 8 whole square plus 8 minus 8 whole square plus 9 minus 8 whole square plus 9 minus 8 whole square divided by n minus 1. So what is here n? It is 5, so 5 minus 1, So it will be like 2 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 plus 1 divided by 4 to power half. So it will be equal to 3, 4. Sorry, so it will be 2 square, na? So it will be here 4. So it will be like 6 by 4 power half. So now if you calculate this 6 by 4 to the power half, I am doing the calculation. So it is like 1.22. Okay, so the answer of this would be around 1.22. So if you round off to 1, so it will be like 1.2. Okay, guys. Next question. A 50 centimeter long rod is placed against a vertical wall such that the bottom of the rod is 30 centimeter away from the wall. If the bottom of the rod is pulled horizontally away from the wall at 4 centimeter per second, the top of the rod starts sliding down the wall with an instantaneous velocity in centimeter per second around of two decimal places of magnitude. Okay, so this is a very good question actually. You see, suppose this is a wall, right? And in this wall, you have a rod of 50 centimeter. Initially, it is at 40 cm. Sorry, this is at 30 cm, right? So, what will be this distance? It will be 40 cm according to Pythagoras, right? Fine, till now we have this data. Now what is happening? This rod is being moved, right? So when it is moved slightly away from this wall in the x direction, so it will move with a velocity that is equal to, here in the x direction it is like dx by dt, that is equal to 4. Fine, so this will decrease. So this will also travel with some velocity, that will be equal to dy by dt. Okay, so this is the case. Now guys, for any time, so you will have to think here how you will apply this concept dx by dt and dy by dt. So it is somewhat related with this differential equation, right? Till now it is fine from here. Okay, now think. See, we have one thing which is fixed over here, that is the length of this rod. So if there is some distance like x and there will be some distance y, so this x and y will be such that x square plus y square will be always equal to 50 square. Let be any speed, any distance, let it be anything, right? So x and y both are suppose variable, right? So now guys, since x and y varies with time, right? So we need to differentiate it. So differentiate it with respect to time. Okay, now guys, when we differentiate it with respect to time, so this becomes 2x dx by dt plus 2y dy by dt is equal to 0. So this implies dy by dt is equal to minus x by y dx by dt. Fine, till now it is fine. Okay. Now guys, see what are the things which are given over here. We have been given this dx by dt and x and y. See, dy by dt we need to find instantaneous when initially it was at 30 centimeter, right? And since at that time this y distance was 40 centimeter, right? So for instantaneous x equal to 30 centimeter, y is equal to 40 centimeter, and dx by dt is equal to 4. So what will be this dy by dt? It will be minus x. X is how much? 30, and it is 40, and it is 4. So it will be like minus 3. So this dy by dt means the speed it is showing in negative direction. Why it is showing in negative direction? Because this y distance is decreasing, right? So basically, so the speed will be, so dy by dt will be equal to 3 centimeter. So in sliding down. Okay, so the answer will be like this. Okay guys, next. The probability of solving a problem by student A is 1/3. Okay, so the probability of solving is 1/3 by student A, and the probability of solving the same problem by student B means A can solve means it can give correct answer, it means it is 1/3. So it can give incorrect answer, it will be 2/3. B, it can give correct answer by 2/5. So incorrect answer, it will be 3/5, right? Now guys, see, the question is the probability that at least one of the students solves the problem. Okay, so probability of at least one student solves it. So what are the chances? Chances is that A can solve, B cannot solve, right? Next chance is A cannot solve and B can solve. Third chance is A can solve and B can also solve, right? The fourth chance will be A is not able to solve and B is also not able to solve. Fine, these are four cases it will be. But see, the question here, it has been asked that at least one of the student is able to solve. So these three conditions will be valid. So it will be like probability will be equal to, what is the probability that A is solving this question? So 1/3, it will be like 1/3 into B not able to solve, right? So not able to solve, that means 3/5 plus A not able to solve means 2/3 into B able to solve, 2/5 plus A is able to solve, 1/3, B is able to solve, 2/5, right? A is not able to solve and B is not able to solve, we will not take, because this is not the question which it is asking. Because here at least it has given you the condition that at least one of the student is solved, means the question is being solved. But here in the last case, the question is not being solved. So we can write it like 3/15 plus 4/15 plus this 2/15. So it will be like 15, 3 plus 4, 7, so it will be 9. So 3/5, so it will be 0.6. Okay, so the answer here it will be 0.6. let us check once again. 3/15, 4/15 is not able to solve, 2/3, B is able to solve, 2/5. Okay, yeah, so the answer will be 0.6. okay, let us proceed. Numerical value of work done rounded off to the nearest integer by a position dependent f equal to xi plus 5xyj, where I and j are unit vectors along the path. Okay, so this is the path, y is equal to, this is the path, right? Okay, since this is the path and it is varying from 0, 0 to 2, 2, right, in the xy plane. Okay, so now we have this force, that is xi plus 5xyj, right? Now see, this force is varying in the x direction also, and this j represents means in the y direction also. So this is a planar force. So when we try to find the work done, so it will be also integral in a planar form, right? So this work done, so dw will be f dot, it will be like f dot dxi plus dyj. So it will be like x dx, right, plus 5xy dy dw. So we need to find complete work done, so we'll do integration. So this w will be equal to x square by 2 plus cm. Guys, if you see here in the right hand side, it is 5xy dy, right? And guys, we know this x and y both are variable over here, so we'll have to find some relation between x and y also, right? So how we'll find the relation, it is like, see, y is equal to, we know, x square by 2. So this implies dy is equal to x dx, fine. So this dy is equal to x dx. Now, so can we replace this one as 5 into x, y is equal to, it will be x square by 2, and this dy we can change it with x dx, or you can do the different thing like y also you can do as for your convenience, right? So now this integration, and this integration has been, is going to be from 0 to 2, right? So we'll write like 0 to 2. So 0 to 2, so it will be 4 by 2 plus, so it will be 5 by 2, so x4, so it will be x5 by 5, and 0 to 2, so it will be 2 plus 5 by 2 into 2 to the power 5, it will be 32 by 5. So it will be like 16. So 2 plus 16, so it will be 18. So this work done will be 18 joule, basically considering that x and y are in meter and this force is in newton. So basically the work done will be equal to 18, fine. So this is one method to solve. Okay, next, the estimated value of the cube root of 37 rounded off to 2 decimal places obtained from the Newton-Raphson method after 2 iterations. Okay, so guys, this is a problem of Newton-Raphson method, and guys, we know the formula of Raphson method, that is xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn minus f dash of xn. So this is asking you for 2 iterations, right? So it has provided this x0 is equal to 1. So what will be this x1? Will be equal to x0 minus f x0 divided by f dash x0, fine. So let us find this first value. So it will be 1 minus f x0, so it will be, okay, oh, so this is okay, let us stop here. But see, what will be the function here? So in for the function, we'll have to define, like, we need to find some x value, right? And this x value should be equal to 37 to the power 1 by 3, because cube root of 37. So can we write this one as x cube is equal to 37? So this implies x cube minus 37 equal to 0. So this fx, we have built it like x cube minus 37, right? So what will be this f dash x? It will be 3x square, fine. So now we'll proceed here. will proceed here. So it will be x1 is equal to 1 minus, so it will be 1 cube minus 37 divided by 3 into 1 square. So it will be 1 plus 36 by 3, so 12, so it will be 13. So x1 after one iteration, 1 represents here one iteration. Okay, so x1 it is 13. So what is this x2? X2 will be equal to x1 minus f of x1 divided by f dash of x1. So it will be like 13 minus 13 cube minus 37 divided by 3 into 13 square, right? So do this calculation, you will have to use calculator. So here 13 minus 4.26. So this is equal to 13 minus 4.26. It is 8.74. So this x2 is equal to 8.74. Okay guys, so this is the answer. Okay, so hope guys this will help you for the preparation. Thank you all.